A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. From that time on, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord. No such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay everyone according to his conduct. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, on the 22nd Sunday Gospel, Jesus exhorts us, Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. Most of us wear a cross on a chain around our necks. Probably a lot of you who listen to this sermon too. You have certainly received the cross as a present for a special occasion or celebration in your life, with a blessing, with the wish that Jesus may accompany you on your life path. The readings of this Sunday reminds us that Christians are called to live their lives in a different way from others around them. Christian discipleship demands honesty, the willingness to suffer, generosity, and readiness to follow Jesus by obeying his commandments of love. Jesus realized that although he had predicted his suffering and death three times, his disciples were still thinking in terms of a conquering Messiah, a warrior king who would sweep the Romans from Palestine and lead Israel to power. That is why Peter could not bear the idea of a suffering Messiah. It was then that Jesus rebuked him so sternly, Get behind me, Satan, in an attempt to nullify what was in fact a temptation of the devil, one urging him to shrink from doing the work for which he had come. It was the same kind of rebuke he had delivered to Satan in the wilderness. Origen suggests that Jesus was saying to Peter, Peter, your place is behind me, not in front of me. It is your job to follow me in the way I choose, not to try to lead me in the way you would like me to go. Satan is banished from the presence of Christ, and Peter is called to become again Christ's follower. Every one of us has to face hurdles in this life. What is the cross in your life? What are the hurdles that we face in our life? Today's gospel passage reminds us that Christian discipleship demands self-control, the willingness to suffer, the readiness to follow Jesus by obeying his commandment of love. The cross, when embraced with love and a trust in God, can touch the hearts and open the minds of others as well. In this way, it will become salvific for you and for those who know you. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. As disciples of Jesus, we need to examine our conscience. Did I sacrifice a part of my life, my time, my talents, and income for my parish and the missionary activities of the church? Did I practice self-control over my thoughts, words, deeds, and use of mass media? Did I train my children in my faith, in a loving, providing, redeeming God by encouraging them as we spend some time together as a family, praying and reading the Bible, and by teaching them through example and word to pardon each other? Let me conclude with an ancient legend about Saint Peter. At the time of the great persecution under Nero, the Christians of Rome told Peter to leave. "You are too valuable," they said. "Get out of town, find your safety. Go to another place and preach the gospel." Peter hastily hurried out of town as fast as he could. But as he hurried along the Appian Way, away from the eternal city, he was met by Christ going toward the city. Peter said to him in Latin, "Quo vadis, Domine?" "Where are you going, Lord?" To which Jesus replied, "Back to Rome to be crucified with my people." "Where are you going, Peter?" Peter's eyes filled with tears of remorse as he turned and walked back to Rome, where, according to tradition, he was crucified head downward, feeling that he was not worthy to die in the same manner as had his Lord. Jesus' question to Peter comes to us also. Where are you going? Are we going with Christ or away from Him and from His cross? That's the really important question. It doesn't matter how far we have traveled. What does matter is the direction in which we are going. Let us ask the Lord the strength to carry our daily cross and follow Him. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? I wish you all a blessed Sunday.